In this presentation, let us continue our discussion on various operations of signals. So, a signal can be either be modified by changing its time axis or by changing its amplitude axis. So, under time operations, we have time shifting operation, time scaling operation, and time reversal operation. And under time amplitude, under amplitude operations, we have amplitude scaling and amplitude reversing. So, we've seen all of this in the previous video. So, let's just have a brief recap of that. So, what is time shifting operation? If x of t is changed to x of t minus t naught, t minus t naught, it is said to be right shifted by t naught, where t naught is greater than 0. And if x of t is changed to x of t plus t naught, it is said to be left shifted by t naught. What is time scaling? Is if x of t is changed to x of t by alpha, then it is shifted to be time scaled. And now if mod alpha is greater than 1, it is said to be expanded version of x of t. And if mod alpha is less than 1, it is said to be compressed value of x of t. And if x of t is changed to x of minus t, it is said to be time reversed. And coming to the amplitude operations, we have amplitude scaling. If x of t is changed to alpha times x of t, its amplitude is increased by a value alpha and is multiplied by a value alpha, And if x of t is changed to minus x of t, its amplitude is reversed. Note, an important note, time shifting scaling reversing is always done with respect to t only and not with respect to the entire variable. So now let's understand this. If x of 2t minus 3 is to be time reversed, then what we need to do is we need to replace t by minus t. We get x of minus 2t minus 3. This is correct. And this is incorrect. You don't have to apply minus sign to the entire variable. All you need to do is just replace t by minus t. This is incorrect and this is correct. And similarly, another example, suppose if you have x of 2t and you are time shifting it by t naught, left shifting by t naught suppose. So, it will become x of 2 replace t by t minus t naught. This thing is correct and x of 2t minus t naught, this is absolutely incorrect. So, what you need to remember here is, this point is very important, most of us end up making mistakes over here. If you perform any time operation, always remember, replace with respect to t only, do not replace the entire variable. Here we are replacing t by minus t, here we are replacing t by t minus t naught. Do not replace the entire variable. And the second note, when you perform time reversal, what you need to do is, you need to flip the signal about the amplitude axis, and when you're performing amplitude reversal, you need to flip the signal about the time axis. So let's understand all these operations using a few examples. So this is x of t, it is given, and we need to plot x of t minus 2, that is right shifted by 2 units. So what we're doing, we're just shifting this by 2 units. And similarly, what is x of t plus 2? It is being left shifted by 2 units. The amplitude is remaining same, it is being left shifted. Now what is x of 2t? X of 2t, if you compare it with x of t by alpha. So what is alpha in this case? Alpha is 1 by 2. So what you need to do in this case, you need to multiply every time instant by a factor alpha, that is 1 by 2 in this case. So what's happening, 0 is multiplied by 1 by 2, it is 0, 1, and you have multiplied the entire time axis here, you end up getting this signal. And if you consider x of t by 2, now here alpha in this case is 2, so every time instant is getting multiplied by 2, so this signal is being expanded, and in the previous case the signal was getting compressed. So an easy way to remember this is, if x of t is an audio tape, then x of 2t will be the audio tape being played at twice the speed. And if something is being played at twice the speed, then obviously its duration will get halved. And x of 2, t by 2 will be the audio tape being played at half the speed. And if something is played at 0.5 speed, then obviously its length will double. And hence this signal will come. Now what is x of minus t? Time reverse signal. This is just flipping, as we said in the second point in the note, in the previous slide. Just flip the signal about the amplitude axis, the x-axis, and you will get this signal. and the amplitude operation, if you perform 2x of t, the amplitude is being changed and all the other things remain same. And minus x of t, that is, we are just flipping the signal about the time axis and we end up getting this signal. So here we saw how we perform different time operations and amplitude operations. Amplitude operations are very simple. Time operations, at times, they are slightly tricky. So let's understand them properly by looking at a few examples. So in this question, we are asked to find out x of 2t minus 3 and x of t is given. So we can do this in two ways. First, we can shift x of t by 3 units, we get x of t minus 3, and then we can scale it by a factor 2. So x of t minus 3 now becomes x of 2t minus 3. Please keep in mind the important note that we discussed earlier. If we scale x of t minus 3, it will become x of 2t minus 3 and not x of 2t minus 6. Now, let's look at the graph. X of t is this. If you shift it by 3 units, this graph is plotted. And then, if you scale it by 2 units, that is t by alpha, alpha is 1 by 2, the entire time axis is getting divided by 2. And method 2, this is the final answer. And in method 2, what we are doing is, we are scaling first. Instead of shifting first, we are scaling first. And then we are shifting. Now, remember, we need to replace t by some amount of shift. If we replace t by t minus 3 here, what we end up getting is we get x of 2t minus 6, which is something we don't want. We want x of 2t minus 3. So what we need to do is, instead of shifting by 3, we shift it by 3 by 2. We are adjusting it. Anyhow, it's getting multiplied by 2 on the outside. So we end up getting x of 2t minus 3. So if we just look at this, x of t is this signal, then x of 2t is compressed version of x of 2t, we end up getting this signal, and then if you shift it by 3 by 2 units, everything is shifted by 3 by 2 units, you end up getting this signal. And if you compare the two signals, they both are the same. The methods, the approach is different, but the final answer remains same. Now, since here we are actually taking out something common and we are deciding by what amount to shift in order to get the correct answer, so this method is slightly tricky. And the above method, first shifting and then scaling, is usually preferred. Now let's combine shifting and reversing. Earlier we had combined shifting and scaling, right? Now let's combine shifting and reversing. So we need to plot x of minus t plus 3. Again, we have two methods. First, we can shift x of t to x of t plus 3, and then we can reverse it. X of t plus 3 will become x of minus t plus 3. Again, remember, only we have to change t. We do not have to multiply minus to the entire variable. Change with respect to t only, not with respect to the entire variable. This point you need to always keep in mind. So x of t is being left shifted. T plus 3, plus indicates left shift. So it is being left shifted. And if you left shift this signal by 3 units, you get this signal. And if you flip, now you need to reverse, right? So you need to flip about the amplitude axis. You end up getting, this is the final answer. And method 2, first, earlier we shifted first and then we reverse. Now let's do the opposite. Let's reverse first and then let's shift. If you reverse first, you get this signal. And now, in order to get x of minus t plus 3, what you need to do is, keeping that point in mind, which we discussed earlier, you need to get minus t minus 3. So we need to shift by 3 units towards the right, in order to get minus t plus 3. If we shift towards the left by 3 units, we end up getting x of minus t minus 3, which has not been asked. So, what we are doing, we have reversed the signal and then we are shifting it towards the left. I just explained why we are shifting it towards the right, we are shifting it towards the right in order to get x of minus t plus 3. Again, if we observe, both the final answers are same, but this was slightly tricky. It's easy if you try and understand it properly, but this is direct. It isn't as complicated as this is, the second method is. Now, in the previous two problems, in the first problem we combined shifting and scaling, and in the second problem we combined shifting and reversing. Now let's combine all the three properties and see what happens. So in this question, he's asking 2 into x of minus 2 minus 3. So this is amplitude scaling, this is time reversing, this is time scaling, and this is time shifting. And given signal x of t looks something like this. So what we can do is, again we can solve it in two methods, actually more than two methods. Let's discuss only two here. So first we are shifting, x of t is being shifted to x of t minus 3. So this signal is being right shifted to 3 units. So this is x of t minus 3, and then we are scaling it by 2 units. Notice how we are getting our required final result step by step, one at a time, one thing at a time. So x of t minus 3 is being scaled to x of 2 minus 3. So when you scale by t by 1 by 2, you need to actually multiply the entire time axis by a factor of 1 by 2. So entire thing is getting multiplied by 1 by 2. And then what we need to do is time reverse. If you reverse the signal, you need to flip it about the magnitude axis, you end up getting this signal. And then you have amplitude scaling, which I've not drawn it separately again. I've just multiplied the amplitude by 2. It was 2 and 1 earlier, now it's 4 and 2. This is 2 and this is 4. Now let's solve the same problem by another approach. First, let's reverse. In the previous method, we had reversed in the last step. Now let's reverse first. We get x of minus t. Then we need to get x of minus 2, right? So let's scale it, x of minus 2t, and then we have to shift it. So we cannot directly shift it by 3 units. So let's just adjust it in such a way that we get minus 3. So if you observe, if you shift it by t plus 3 by 2, and when it gets multiplied by minus 2 on the outside, it becomes minus 2t. The 2's cancel and we get minus 2t minus 3. Hence we need to shift it by 3 by 2 units towards the left side, plus indicates left side. So let's perform this method step by step. This signal is first being reversed, and this reverse signal is being scaled by factor 2. So all the entire time axis gets multiplied by a factor 1 by 2. And now what we're doing is we're shifting it towards the left by a factor by 1.5 towards the left. So 0 is now on minus 1.5. And minus 0.5, minus 1.5 will become minus 2. Minus 1, minus 1.5 is minus 2.5. And minus 1.5, minus 1.5 will become minus 3. So notice how these two answers are also same. The methods might be different, but the final answer, the final plot of 2x of minus 2 into minus 2 minus 3 will remain same. So notice how in all the three problems, when we shift it first, the problem was a bit simpler. But if we shift in the last, the problem slightly becomes trickier. Why? Because we need to adjust t. But in the above case, we don't have to adjust t. Simply, if we do one step at a time, we end up getting the final result. So now we've solved three problems, and each problem we've solved using two methods. Both the methods are right, but the first method was slightly simpler, as we didn't have to adjust the value of t in the first method. So what we can do is, an important note over here, for convenience, follow this order. First perform time shifting, then perform time scaling, then perform time reversal, and then you can perform any amplitude operation. Amplitude operations are simpler, they are not an issue. So this is the order you need to remember. Thanks for watching the video, and I've uploaded this PDF which I've used in the link in the description of the video. You can find it over there. Thank you very much.